Imagine you have a power to create objects you want. You just push some buttons and voila, creates your sculpture or a tool. Sounds amazing, right? That's what 3D printers can do for you. But before you get too excited, you should know, it's not as easy as it sounds. There are some hidden problems that can ruin your magic experience, like this one.
I wanted to make a lamp, and if you're a complete beginner like I was a couple months ago, you're probably thinking, well, 3D printer can totally print it as a whole piece. Actually no, it divides like this, and the reason why is the supports. First pitfall. They prevent the printed object from collapsing, but they're also hard to remove and sometimes damage your object in the process. Now after dividing the whole piece, here's our second pitfall. We somehow need to build it back, and that's tricky, cause some joints are hard to model and others take longer to connect. Next one is fragility. This is the weakness of a printed object, caused by the layering process. Final for today, tolerance. Let's say you have a detail that goes inside the printed one, and it's 35mm. Naturally, we would make a hole 35mm as well, but it doesn't work like that. We need the tolerance. Don't get me wrong, this is a wonderful technology that can unleash your creativity and imagination. But it also has its challenges and limitations, and by knowing these four hidden problems and how to avoid them, you can make your experience much more enjoyable. So here are my solutions. So to avoid the first problem, we design objects that do not need supports. Look at this tent. We divided it into three pieces and avoided supports completely by just tweaking the model. Same story here. Create 45 degree surfaces for parts that should be overhanging, like this. Even this lock, it's printed with no supports. Now about the joints. There are so many of them, which need a dedicated video just for that. I'll cover only three that I used in this lamp. The thread insert method is the most reliable and easy to make, but sometimes we need an easy to take apart joint, like this one. Perfect for this case, cause we need to change the light bulb sometimes. But it's hard to model. Unlike the next one, threads. If you're using Fusion 360 as your modeling software, there is a dedicated tool for that. You can also download different models from this website for free. But the problem with threads is that it's not so strong with small objects. And we are stepping into the third problem, fragility. This material is not the plastic we are used to in our everyday life. It's more fragile, cause of the layering. To strengthen my joint, I used a screw in a bolt center. Apart from the fact that there is a screw now, these outer walls make it stronger as well. Second thing you should keep in mind is the print orientation. So if you were to screw something in this block, it's preferable to go from this side. We've covered three pitfalls already. To cover the last one, let me go to this detail. As I've mentioned before, we can't just use the exact dimensions. We have to give some gaps. 0.2mm gap works most of the time. But in this instance, I had to use 0.4mm for a snug fit. But a rule of thumb would be to use 0.2mm and adjust on the fly. Now let's check how all of this applies on a real project.
printable STL files to the first 20 people that email me free stuff to this address. For others to get these STL files, you will have to subscribe to my Patreon. You will also get molds, step-by-step guides and other useful stuff. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.